Hello and welcome, coders and learners, to this lesson on Coding with Sean. My name is Sean, and I will be your instructor today. In this lesson, we will compare 8 different browsers and their capabilities, including their upsides and downsides. Those browsers include the old Microsoft Edge, the new Microsoft Edge, the Onion Router, better known as Tor, Google Chrome, Mozilla Firefox, Apple's Safari, Opera, and Brave. So without further ado, let's begin. Let's talk about our major engines. What an engine is the foundation and core of a browser. An engine's main purpose is to transform HTML code into a visual representation for a user. So our major engines include Chromium, which was developed by Google but worked on by many other freelancers and corporations, including Microsoft, and is used by Google Chrome, the new Microsoft Edge, Opera, and Brave. Our next major engine is Gecko, which was developed by Netscape and is used by Firefox and Tor. Our next major engine is actually HTML, which is not so much an engine as it is code, but Microsoft is pretty ingenuitive and it used that ingenuity to transform HTML code into something that can read HTML code. And this is used by the old Microsoft Edge. And our final major engine is WebKit, which was developed by Apple and is used by Safari as well as all other browsers on Apple platforms. So let's talk about the benefits and issues with these major engines. Starting with Chromium, it includes the benefits of being fast when there are a few tabs open. It is very widely used and understood, meaning it is easier to get support should you have any problems. And Google Chrome in particular is generally easier to use with other Google products. Its downsides include that it can get very slow if more than 5 to 10 tabs are open. It uses far more of your CPU than it actually needs to, and it is not quite as fast as Gecko run browsers if you are trying to upload or download files. Next up, we have HTML and WebKit. Its benefits are that it does not get as slow as Chromium if you open lots of tabs. It is simple, and it has a reasonably good user interface. Its downsides are that its simplicity gives it fewer useful and cool features. It sacrifices good quality tabs and windows for simplicity, and it is very, very slow compared to Gecko or Chromium, particularly when there are a few tabs open. So with Gecko, you have the benefits of being fast, even if you open a lot of tabs, very, very fast uploads and downloads, much faster than either Chromium or HTML and WebKit, and it has a reasonably good user interface too. Matter of fact, it's quite good. Its downsides are that it isn't as user-friendly as Chromium-based browsers, and it isn't as compatible with Google products as Google Chrome. So let's talk about these benefits and issues with the browsers in particular. So beginning with Google Chrome, it is the most widely used browser in the world. It is very fast, but only using a few tabs. It is the most compatible browser with Google products. However, it does exemplify the issue with Chromium-based browsers when it comes to being very, very slow when more than a few tabs are open. The new Microsoft Edge, developed in January of 2020 by Microsoft Corporation, has an easy-to-use and good-looking interface. It is faster than most other browsers when few tabs are open. But for this, it becomes the worst and slowest browser in terms of speed if more than 5 tabs are open. The other major downside is that Windows may not let you uninstall Edge, which has become a serious problem and a serious debate over whether Microsoft is trying to steal your data. Next up, we have Safari and the old Microsoft Edge. For Safari, it is the most widely used browser on iOS and macOS. It is quite fast, even if lots of tabs are open. It's the most compatible browser with iOS products. and it isn't as easy to use as most Chromium-based browsers, however, and it lacks a good extension store, something you see in pretty much all HTML and generally WebKit-based browsers. The old Microsoft Edge has an easy-to-use interface. It comes with Windows. You don't have to install anything. It's quite fast, even if lots of tabs are open. However, the problems are that it may not let you uninstall Edge. It is not as good to the eyes, which can eventually lead to slower usage due to you having a little bit of issues with trying to find where stuff is. And it lacks a good extension store, something that you see a lot, again, in HTML browsers. So next up, we have the Tor browser by Tor Project Incorporated. It is the most private, it's widely regarded as the most private browser in the world. It has an onion format proxy / VPN, which includes 3 layers of encryption. It collects hardly any to no data. It is quite harder to add extensions, which can only be downloaded off the Firefox add-on store. It is quite literally, though, a copy-paste of Firefox with a little bit more privacy. And should a site not have SSL, your identity could be revealed for brief moments, or in worst-case scenarios, completely reveal your identity. Next up, we have Mozilla Firefox, the new one at least. It is far faster than any other browser if multiple tabs are open. It gives you a widely used interface, short to Chromium, but nonetheless very widely used and easy to get support for. It is more private than Chromium-based browsers. And it was developed by a nonprofit, which in their own words, quote, protects the health of the internet, unquote. The other disadvantage is that it can fall short to Chromium-based browsers in terms of speed if fewer than 5 tabs are open. Next up, we have Opera, which is one of the best Chromium-based browsers in terms of speed if many or few tabs are open. It collects limited data. It has an inbuilt VPN with 3 servers. However, it has a very limited extension store, though it somewhat makes up for that by being able to download extensions off the Chrome Web Store. However, it is reported to have potentially collected private data, and it sometimes runs data through China, the People's Republic of China, which may result in your data actually being stored by China, which has become a huge privacy debate. Brave Browser by Brave Incorporated is the fastest Chromium browser by a personal experiment by me when lots of tabs are open. It is regarded to be the most private Chromium-based browser. It has private windows with Tor enabled in it. It has the disadvantages, though, of Chrome without the added support for Chrome Google products, and it still does lack speed if lots of tabs are open. So the old Mozilla Firefox is generally known to be more private than Chrome and other Chromium-based browsers. It was a revolutionary browser for the time, and this marks the transition from Mozilla Firebird to Mozilla Firefox. It is slower than modern-day Firefox and most browsers of today. It is not nearly as secure as the new Firefox. It has more loading issues and crashing issues than almost all of today's browsers. And the most significant disadvantage is that it is a legacy browser, meaning that should something go wrong, you're probably not going to get any support and certainly not get refunded or compensated. So, a conclusion. Chromium is good for speed and integration with third-party products, but there is an issue of crashing and doing crashing-like things when more than a few tabs are open and it uses more of your CPU than necessary. Gecko is good for supporting many tabs or windows without using more of your CPU than needed, keeping relatively good speed. It does fall short of Chromium when measuring speed without too many tabs or windows. And lastly, it also has less users, meaning less support. WebKit and HTML are generally the same benefits and problems. The benefits include that it is simple, easy to use, and fast, but you do sacrifice cool and useful features, and also may risk giving data you do not wish to give to companies. This was a relatively short lesson, and it is a little bit different than things I usually do. And I really do appreciate for all the people who watch this video, and please do subscribe if you think that this video is good. If you do have any feedback, comments, or questions, you can go ahead and put them down in the comment section below, and I will certainly answer you if it needs an answer. And yes, thank you so much, and please do check out my other videos to learn more.